Folks worry that pesticides sprayed on our foods might cause cancer. And I think that's, you know, a legitimate concern. The Food and Drug Administration tells us that the pesticides that are approved to be used on our produce, for example, and in the dosing that's typically used on our foods, do not increase the risk of cancer in any way in terms of any convincing studies. That said, there are farm worker studies out there that, you know, for these folks who work on the farms and are exposed on a daily basis to pesticides, they do have an increased risk of developing a variety of different cancers in some studies. So that would be suggestive that maybe there is a direct linkage between some of these pesticides, at least in higher doses perhaps, and the development of a variety of different types of cancers. My recommendation is, whenever possible, try to buy foods that are not sprayed with pesticides. So that would be a labeling that would say organic. If you can afford organic foods, that would be my recommendation. Otherwise, one of the things you could also do is go to one of my favorite websites, which is the Environmental Working Group, or EWG.org, and look at their list that they produce each year called the Dirty Dozen and the Clean 15. And what you can do is you can find the produce that are on the Dirty Dozen list. Those are the ones that are considered the most toxic of them. Those are the ones that have most of the pesticide residues. And top of that list, by the way, is an apple that's supposed to keep the doctor away. So what I would do is I would buy my produce organically from the Dirty Dozen list, and then they have another list called the Clean 15. Those are the cleanest of the produce, and those you could save your money and just buy those in terms of conventional. So again, whenever possible, if you can afford it, try to buy organic because of the toxic exposures that hopefully will be less in those products.
Hi, I'm Wendy Hartley, co-founder of Breast Cancer Answers. You know, not every breast cancer patient benefits from chemotherapy. When I was diagnosed, my doctor thought I would need chemotherapy. But then I learned about the Oncotype DX test, which helps your doctor decide if chemotherapy could benefit you based on the unique biology of your tumor. My test results revealed I had a very low chance of my cancer returning, which meant I didn't need chemotherapy after all. To learn more about the Oncotype DX test, click this button here.